Well, we welcome you to this wedding today, and we invite you to be seated at this time. You know, God is the author of love, and the Bible teaches that God is love and that love comes from God. From beginning to end, the Bible is a love story. And from the beginning to the end, we see where God's love is for his people, of a love that sent Christ to the cross, of redeeming love for all of us who have sinned, and of abiding love for the redeemed. We also read of the love of a man and a woman in the Bible as well, Adam and Eve. And this is why we've come today, to celebrate Casey and Christina and to witness their joining together in holy matrimony. God has guided Casey and Christina to this moment, and he's blessed them, blessed their love and brought them together. And so we're grateful and thankful today. So I have a question for you, Casey Edward Harjo. Will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the holy bond of marriage? Will you love her and honor her and care for her under all conditions and circumstances of life? And through the grace of God, be a faithful Christian husband to her so long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
And Christina Dawn Ebert, I have this question for you. Will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the holy bond of marriage? Will you love him, honor him, and care for him under all conditions and circumstances of life, and through the grace of God, be a faithful Christian wife to him so long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you've made us male and female and given us the desire to leave father and mother and be united to become one love, one flesh. And we thank you for the love that we see in these two today. And we believe that as you've brought them to this day, we ask for your blessing as they exchange their vows and seal their promises. As they become husband and wife, Lord, may they do so not only in our presence, but in yours, with your grace surrounding them and your love within their hearts. We pray this through Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let's come this way. The ceremony of marriage, which you come to be united in today, is the first and oldest ceremony in the world, celebrated at the beginning in the presence of God himself. Marriage is a gift of God, and it's given to comfort the sorrows of life and magnify its joys. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of hearts, the union of two lives as one. And so your marriage must stand not by the authority of the state or the seal on your wedding certificate, by the strength of your love, actually, and by the power of your faith in each other and in God. So when you get married, you start out in an apartment. Later on, maybe you'll buy a house. You might even buy a mansion someday. But one thing you will never buy, you cannot buy a home. A home is something that exists apart from whether you have an apartment or a house. A home is not only where you live, but it's also how you live. A home is how you abide. Another word for home in the Bible is an abode, which comes from the word abide. The man and the woman in the Garden of Eden, they didn't have a house or an apartment. They had a home in the sense that they had a relationship based on the wisdom and grace of God. They were created by God to be one of one another. And it was only after they were driven from the garden that they actually ended up with a house. But they faced the challenge of making that house into a home that would survive in spite of their human selfishness. A home is not such a place as it is a state of mind. A husband and wife can't create this state of mind on their own, try as they might. A home where love abides in the family, and the family abides in the love of God, is a gift from God. A home where a family shares what God's love produces: compassion, kindness, humility, patience, forgiveness. Such a home is based on nothing less than the gospel of Jesus. So Casey and Christina, the love God has created for you will be with you for your journey through life. It's nurtured you through parents and family and teachers and friends, and this love caused you to find each other, and now it's brought you to this day, your wedding day. And no matter where you went or what you did, that love abided with you. And I hope that it may continue to abide with you throughout your coming years together. As husband and wife, you can rent an apartment. You can even buy a house. But a home for you will always be a gift and not a possession. May you always have the love of Jesus Christ, which abides in your hearts, no matter where you are. You can have this kind of home as you continue to recognize God as the source of romance and love and affection. These are his gifts. So build your home on that spiritual foundation. That's why we're here today. With God, you'll have everything. Without him, you'll be missing out. So we next have ring vows, and so I need to ask for someone to bring us the rings. Now, before you place those rings on each other's fingers, I want to share a scripture. And so why don't you just join one hand from each of you together while you're listening to this. From 1 Corinthians 13, it says, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm a resounding gong or just a clanging cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but I don't have love, I have nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but I have not love, I gain nothing." Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Now, these three things remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Would you repeat after me these words of your marriage vows before we do your ring vows? I, Casey,